So we have come here as the Gen Z's from this area, together with the residents of Njoro constituency, to mourn together with the families of those that lost their loved ones during the demonstrations that are ongoing. And we are saddened because the demonstrations are so peaceful, but we came here in solidarity and to show them that we are together, the families of those that have died, that we are so much together with them. And we are appreciating the fallen heroes because they died for the right cause. We condemn these deaths because they were not supposed, they should not have happened in the first place, because our protests were very peaceful and in accordance with the constitution of Kenya. So we are condemning the killings of the young people, and we want to demand justice from those that are involved. We are demanding justice from the Ministry of Interior. We are demanding justice. That those that killed our young people must be brought to book. And this time round, it is not just making noise. We are demanding justice. Else, we are going to strike until you guys, you've never seen what is coming. Until these deaths are avenged. Until these deaths have found rest, knowing that the justice have been served. We are not going to relent at the Gen Z's. And we want to say this as I conclude, so, because there are others that are coming, that there are no dialogue that is happening. Whatever the president is saying and calling for multi-sectoral group that is going to air the grievances of the young people of this country, as the Gen Z's, we put it very clear, it is in black and white that we do not have any leader. Even as I speak, I'm not leader of anyone. I'm just one of these people, and they are equally capable of talking the things I'm talking. So we are saying, that there is no one that will represent us in that multi-sectoral group, because there's nothing that will come out of it. Just as NADCO report went into the grass and there is nothing to show for it, having killed so many young people, we want to tell them that no, thank you. We want our demands met to the latter. We want you, Ruto, to address the real issues. And the main one that we are saying is that you must resign, because you are incapable of leading this country. You have proven so incapable of leading this country, and these people, especially the Gen Z's, it is us that believed you with the seat you occupy. But because you have shown us that you are so incapable of leading us, we are telling you that you must calm down, we must have re-elections. And lastly, we are demanding that kindly, can you reconstitute the IEBC? Because we want to recall all the MPs that voted yes. Because it is from that ignorance, it is from that arrogance that our young people have died. They voted yes against the people's will, and the deaths happened as a result. So we are telling our MPs, all of those that voted yes, starting with the one from Njoro, Madam Charity Kadhambi, we are not resting. You voted yes for this finance against the will of the people, and we are going to recall you. As soon as the IEBC is reconstituted, we are going to start a recall process whereby every MP who voted yes will be recalled, they will lose their seats, and we are going to elect people who are responsible enough to start
the kiongozi wa Gen Z hapa Njoro. Ile kitu tunasema haturudi nyuma. Na Ruto, tungekuomba kabla tujaendelea na hizi siku saba za kuomboleza zimebaki, unafaa kuwa umejiuzuru na umepack vilago zako umeelekea Sugoi. Kwa vile umetuonesha hauna uwezo, hauna capability ya kuongoza nchi. Na kuna kitu moja tunataka kuambia bwana Rigiji. We are not going to beg MPs ambao walihongwa na shilingi milioni mbili. Watu wa Njoro hawatoshi milioni mbili. We are the taxpayers of Njoro and of the whole Kenya. Ile kitu tunasema hatuongei nao. Kama unajua ulihongwa, wewe shika shughuli, enda nyumbani. Na Rigiji, wacha kutumika kupakwa uchafi. Vile ulisimama kusema Nurdin Haji ajiondoe, hata sisi tunasema ajiondoe. Na ile kitu tunataka kusema, sheria ifuatwe. Vile koti ilisema ya kwamba musitumie nguvu, musitumie kanosta, hiyo nayo tunasema tunarudi. Na watu wa Njoro nawaambia, kalenda yetu itakuwa siku ya Jumanne na tarehe saba mwezi wa saba ndio
tuliambiwa tukuje na hivi. Okay, tuliambiwa tukuje na black
and
na
white.
Tubebe handkerchief ya white. Na nikati, na ni kwa sababu mimi natambua ya kwamba we have a big problem in our nation Kenya. Mimi sio Gen Z, mimi niko mbele kidogo, millennium. Lakini sisi ndio tunaongea na hii generation. Bible inasema katika Malachi chapter 4 verse 6 ya kwamba ikiwa kutakuwa na disconnection between generation ya wazazi na generation ya young people, Mungu atastrike the earth with a curse. Na hivyo ndio Old Testament ilisha na the word curse. Na kwa hivyo saizi tuko kwa verge kubwa sana ya inchi yetu kukua cast, ikiwa viongozi wetu, tukianza na president, na MPs, na governors, na senators, na MCAs, hawataona ile danger yenye tuko ndani yake. It is a spiritual problem as much as it's a constitutional problem and as much as it's whatever kind of problem we might explain. Na nataka kusema hivi ya kwamba most of the people that have died are not the criminals or the goons, because it is clear that the president has said the criminals and the goons will be watawaendea, wataenda kuwafikia. So kama watajaribu kufikiwa na washikwe, ni kumaanisha wako hai. This means waliokufa ni wale ambao wako goons na criminals. Nataka kuomba hivi ya kwamba kuna wazazi wanalia, kuna wazazi wanaomboleza. Mimi kama spiritual leader, hii mzigo inakuja kwetu, because mzazi ambaye naongoza akifiwa na mtoto, na mtoto wapotee, like saizi watu wamezunguka hapa wana shout wakisema brother yangu haonekani, sister yangu haonekani, mtu wetu haonekani, mwingine ameshikwa. Hiyo yote ikipotea, sisi au wote wakipotea, sisi ndio tuna shida kubwa sana, because hatutalala. Na nitaomba hivi Gen Z's, because I'm a millennium, nitawaomba hivi Gen Z's ya kwamba not every church leader misrepresents you. Sisi ambao huwa tunawaongelea, hata nyinyi wenye vyombo vya habari, nataka mjue hivi, we don't get these platforms. We have tried to create our own media, like our church as a YouTube. We have tried so much, but we don't get, you know, TV is still the biggest media. Social media is still the lowest media. TV is still the biggest media. But those pastors and those spiritual leaders and those that get the power of advocacy to speak on media, sometimes they are the ones who say, we all as pastors have decided, when some of us have not decided. So what they are deciding. So I want to say, we are not against any generation. It is impossible to kill a generation. In the Bible, Pharaoh tried, Pharaoh walijaribu, Herod tried, they killed the boys, they threw them in the Nile so that they may finish a generation, because when boys, unaona the boy child akiuliwa, wote wakiuliwa, mbegu imeisha, si ndio? Yeah. Mbegu inakuwa na kijana ama inakuwa na mwanaume. Kwa hivyo hakuna mwanamke atapandwa mbegu, si ndio?
Yes.
Akikosa hiyo mbegu, hiyo generation imeisha. Hiyo generation imeisha. Kwa hivyo it has been tried. Time comes, you know, generation and generation, they have tried, but they have never succeeded. And even in Kenya, it shall not be possible to finish a generation. Gen Z's, yes. Don't punish the church.
Yes.
Sini sawa?
Yes.
Unajua, kulikuwa na sentiment ilisemwa, ati wakimalizana na parliament, ama na gava, wanafutia church. Sasa sikiza niwaambie, kuna church ambayo ijaihongwa. Kuna church haijawahi patia politician platform. Mimi personally sijawahi patia politician platform.
Kabisa.
Mimi personally sijaitisha, sijakuwa psycho fan wa politician. I'll preach the truth to them. There are many like me that are empathizing with you, they are sympathizing with you, they are praying with you, they are doing everything possible to reach you. I know kuna political leaders ambao pia wapendi church, wameumia, wanaona church imebetray Kenya. Sio wote.
Yeah.
We are here, si ndio?
Yes.
So may God bless you so much.
Amen.
Niedi warianage ko